Hello everyone, I am Ketan Maruti and in this video, me and my team members will explain you about coal mine safety monitoring and alert system. And our project guides are Dr. Ganesh Regulwar sir and Ms. Pushpa Chutel ma'am.
Problem statement and objectives. The major problem identified is that there are numerous accidents occurring in the coal mines due to improper maintenance and inadequate monitoring of the mining activities. The key for controlling coal mine accident is by implementing sensors and microcontrollers and to generate an alarm system before situation gets critical. Objectives: to detect different toxic gases with mining environment, to detect the temperature and dust particles, to provide notification to the supervisor, to provide an alert system for the workers. Introduction: the natural conditions of coal mines are highly complicated and mining conditions are extremely capricious. Many disasters can occur in mines, which increase the insecurity of coal mining and easily leads to major accidents, causing extreme difficulty in establishing safety. When underground mining advances continuously, no wired network can be established in real time. Naturally, it is thus impossible to monitor this dangerous region in real time. In addition, due to cost and maintenance limitation, no safety monitoring systems are installed in the abandoned underground tunnels, creating a great potential safety hazard. Underground mining industry comes to the category where each and every parameter such as methane gas, high temperature, fire accident and so on has to be monitored regularly. Safe production level of coal mine is still low. Disaster in coal mine occur frequently, which lead to great loss of possession and life. Technology use: programming language we have used is embedded C. Hardware we have used is Arduino, dust sensor, GP2Y1010, resistor of 475 ohm, ESP8266, Wi-Fi module, buzzer, MQ5 semiconductor sensor for methane, MQ7 semiconductor sensor for carbon monoxide, DHT11 humidity and temperature sensor, RF433 megahertz transmitter receiver module with Arduino, LM317 linear regulator with adjustable output. For the presentation, I would like to call Roshni.
We have three modules. The very first one is sensor placement and connectivity. The first phase or module of our research purpose are different sensors that are used for detecting the gases, temperature and dust particles. MQ5 sensors is used to detect hydrogen and methane. MQ77 sensor is used to detect carbon monoxide. GP2Y1010 sensor is used to detect the amount of dust particle present in the mine. And DHT11 is used to detect the amount of humidity and temperature. RF module is used for transmitting the data from transmitter to receiver side, while the buzzer will glow after crossing the threshold value. Module 2 is analysis of data from the sensors. In this module, all the sensors will send the data to Arduino and through the RF transmitter, data will be transmitted to RF receiver and analyze the data from all the sensors. After analysis of data, data will be sent to cloud through ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, and then it analyzes the data from all the sensors and saves data in the corresponding values. After analyzing, the data will be sent to cloud through ESP8266 Wi-Fi module. Third and the last module is notification and alert module. In the last module, data will be sent to cloud through crossing the threshold value. Buzzer will glow and workers will soon awaken the mine because of the alarm. And now let's look at the implementation video.
This is the work we have done till now. First, I'll explain all the sensors. This is MQ7 sensor, which is used to detect carbon monoxide gas. This is MQ5 sensor, which is used to detect hydrogen and methane gas. This is a RF module transmitter. It will transmit the data. This is DH11. It is used to detect temperature and humidity. This is PM2.5. It is a dust sensor. This is ESP8266. It is a Wi-Fi module. This is a RF module receiver. This is a buck module. We have used buck module because we need constant power for both these sensors. If we do not use buck module, then we must get garbage values. This adapter is connected. This adapter is connected to the buck module through which we will get the constant power. So now I'll explain the flow of our project. Through this yellow wire, data will be transferred to the Arduino data of PM2.5 dust sensor. Data of MQ7 sensor will be transmitted by this orange wire, and data of MQ5 sensor will be transmitted by this green wire. All these values will be stored in the Arduino, and through this gray wire, which is connected in the 12th pin, will be read by the transmitter. And then the transmitter will transmit the data through this red wire, which is working as an antenna, to the receiver. And after receiving, the receiver will transmit the data through this blue wire to the Arduino. And through this ESP8266 Wi-Fi module, data will be sent to the ThingSpeak server, which will be handled by the manager. When the values will cross the threshold value, then the buzzer will be raised and all the workers will waken the mine.
First, we will log in into the ThingSpeak server, where we need login ID and password. So this is our ThingSpeak login page. So after login, this is our main project page, where all the graphs of are shown. Now after the login, the main process will start. This is the process where all the sensors are analyzing the data and sending the values through packet to the ThingSpeak server. Now we have set the threshold values for all the sensors according to the surrounding. As you can see, the threshold value for humidity is 46 and temperature for 35, and where the methane gas sensor, that is MQ5 sensor, the threshold value is set as 119, and for MQ7 sensor the threshold value set is 590. And last but not the least, the PM2.5 sensor is set as 161. These all are the threshold value set according to our surroundings. Now I'll execute it. Okay, so we have used an incense stick, that is agarbatti, to check the reading. So you can see the MQ7 reading is 654 590. So it is crossed the threshold value, so buzzer is buzz. So now the reading for MQ5 PM2.5 sensor is 191. The humidity is also crossed. So as you can see, the temperature value did not cross the threshold value, so the buzzer did not ring. These are the graph of all the sensors. It is showing according to the time as well as date. We can see the continuous changes in the graph as per value. As our project is for coal mine workers, after crossing the threshold value, an alarm raised and workers immediately vacant the mine. And due to this, no death issue will be occur or no accident will be occur.
So, there are several applications of our project. So, first is it can be installed in labs if there is emission of poisonous gases to alert people working there. Second, it also can be installed in houses or offices where the pest control is done to check whether the effect of chemicals and gases is above the normal level to make sure that place is safe for living. Future scope. With the growing innovation, future work of experimentation may include more development of the system by using other advanced sensors for monitoring the underground threats. Also, all the underground operations can be carried out from ground surface. New developing communication technologies can be used for high speed data transfer in integration with smart sensors for sensing the mine conditions. Also, more IoT enabled systems can be developed for more advanced functionalities.